So today, okay, I will be dealing with how to get license, okay, if you are a nurse. And for everyone, okay, those who are internationally educated nurses, normally we say from 2015, if you want to get your license in Canada, you have to approach through National Nursing Assessment Service, that is NNAS. That's the first step you have to do if you are an internationally educated nurse. But if you have a Canadian education nursing, normally we say, okay, if it is, the Canadian RN or the Canadian diploma, then you can just directly approach the nursing regulatory bodies. You don't have to go through internationally, the NNAS. But most of the nurses, okay, it's very easy. If you already have a diploma or a bachelor's or a master's from India, okay, it's better you start your nursing registration process, that NNAS, before you come to Canada, so that it will be more easy to get into your registration, okay, after a few months. And normally what we say is, once you start the process in NNAS, it will almost take 6 to 8 months for the average time process for the NNAS. And this NNAS is actually for all the regulatory bodies or all the provinces except Quebec. For Quebec, okay, we have a different nursing registration program, that is OIQQ. We will deal with OIQQ and NNAS, okay. So Poncius nursing team, basically we do all the nursing registration assistance that's needed for nurses. So normally we say, if you plan to come to Canada through the student visa, start your process and finish all your paperwork. Paperwork means you have to do the credentials from your, the colleges, from your registration agencies, and also from your employer. So get it done, and then you can come here. Meantime, the NNAS will do your assessment. And if you are planning for PR, from our guidance, from Poncius Nursing Team, our guidance is, it's better you start your process along with your PR process, so that by the time your PR or your approach to Canada will be there, your nursing registration process will be ready, and you can, start work as a nurse once you land in Canada. And Joy said, there are some other options too for nurses. Okay, you can come to Canada as a support worker. Okay, for different provinces there are different support workers, personal support worker, then HCA, that is healthcare aide, and also CCA, so many other. Okay, but the thing is, even if you come to Canada through this channel, ultimately if you are a nurse and if you want to get into your registration, and if you are an internationally educated nurse, you have to go through NNAS. Except for Quebec, for all the other provinces, NNAS will do the initial assessment. And then once you have your report from NNAS, that can be submitted to the regulatory body where we get our eligibility and you can go for the exam. And when it comes to Canada, okay, mainly we say there are only two type of exam here as of now. Right now in 2021, okay, the CPNRE, the Canadian Practical Registered Nurses Examination, that will be finished by 31st of December 2021. From 2022, we are going for NCLEX-PN, and the Registered Nurses Examination in Canada from 2015, that is NCLEX-RN for Registered Nurses, that is NCLEX-RN. And it can be taken, the NCLEX-RN is for registered nurse category, and it can be taken from any part of the world. So start your process from which country you belong, okay? If you are not in Canada, don't worry, okay? Start your process. If you have the eligibility, you can go for the exam. You can write the exam in your home country. So you will be meeting some of the registration requirements, and if only, few are left, then it's very easy to approach an employer if you are going for any work permit or if you are going through any job offer. Unfortunately, I can't see any messages, so I don't know, okay, whether you have any doubts or anything. So those who are nurses, okay, like I said, okay, those who are internationally educated nurses, NNAS is the first step. And if you are already in Canada and if you are an internationally educated nurse, if you haven't started anything, okay, nothing at all, okay, then you can consider two options. Either you can go for the bachelor's in nursing in Canada, which is very expensive, and to be frank, okay, it's not easy to get the studies done, because you already have a license, or if you already are a nurse, okay, then you have your diploma or your bachelor's or master's, then you don't have to repeat the same thing. It's very easy for the nurses to do the NNAS process and then get into your registration. And when you approach us, what we do is specifically, okay, we will assess your file, we will recommend you which regulatory body is good for you based on your file and which nursing category is good for you. Because we will get so many people, you know, they always just approach us to say, hey, I have already started the process, but they don't know whether they will go into eligibility. They just start the process because my friend told, okay, I started with this regulatory body and I applied with this category. Okay, this is the category that I applied. No, don't do that. Before you start the process, it's better you get your file assessed so that we will have an idea whether you need to proceed for that regulatory body or a different regulatory body is good for your file, which category is good for your file. So if there is anything that can be done to get your file more credits, okay, we will guide you. That's what we do in Collinses Nursing Team.